So in this session, let me explain the concept of bearing modulus and bearing characteristic number. Right? In the previous session, we have seen the terminology of hydrodynamic general bearing, or the terms used in the design of hydrodynamic general bearing. Right? Now we will see the concept of bearing modulus or bearing characteristic number. Right, so as we have seen earlier, the coefficient of friction plays a vital role in the design of hydrodynamic general bearing. The coefficient of friction is generally the function of three parameters, Zn by P, comma D by C, and L by D. Right? Coefficient of friction is the function of three parameters, Zn by P, D by C, and L by D. So, where Z is the viscosity of lubricating oil, N is the speed of the journal, P is the bearing pressure calculated based on the projected area of the bearing, and C is diametral clearance, D is the diameter of the journal, L is the length of the bearing, and D is the diameter of the journal. So, these things we already discussed in our earlier session, right? C by D is the diametral clearance ratio. Inverse of diametral clearance ratio is D by C. And L by D is the ratio which is used to differentiate the bearings into long, short, or square bearings. Right? These values, anyway, we can consider it from the data book. Okay. Now, the most important one here in the coefficient of coefficient of friction calculation is the Zn by P value, right? The Zn by P is known as bearing characteristic number. This Zn by P is known as bearing characteristic number. Okay, so the importance of this Zn by P value is explained with the help of a plot between coefficient of friction and Zn by P, right? So the bearing characteristic number or its importance is explained with the help of this plot, that is the plot between coefficient of friction and Zn by P. So Zn by P is simply known as a bearing characteristic number, since it characterizes or it gives the behavior of the bearing, or it characterizes the performance of the bearing. That's why this number Zn by P is called bearing characteristic number, right? So by taking Zn by P on the x-axis, mu or the coefficient of friction on the y-axis, if you draw a plot for different values of Zn by P, you will get a V-shaped curve which will have different slopes on striate regions, right? So this plot is segmented into three parts. PQ region, QR region, and RS region, right? So this PQ region indicates thick film lubrication, or the bearing is under hydrodynamic condition, right? That means the metal to metal contact is completely eliminated. Metal to metal contact is completely eliminated, hence there is no question of friction here in between the journal and the bearing due to metal to metal contact. Obviously, there is no the adverse effects of this friction between P and Q here. Okay, so the Zn by P value, if falls between P and Q, then the bearing is running under stable conditions. The bearing is running under stable conditions. So you can indicate this as stable working region of the journal bearing. Okay, Suppose in this Zn by P, if this value of n decreases, if this value of n decreases or the value of P increases, either the decrease of speed or the increase of the bearing pressure causes decrease in the Zn by P value, decrease in the Zn by P value, then slowly the bearing works in this region between Q and R, where you will find partial lubrication. You cannot avoid a complete metal to metal contact between the journal and the bearing, since it is subjected to high bearing pressures. High bearing pressure in the sense, bearing pressure always calculated based on the projected area, load divided by projected area. Projected area is nothing but L into D, right? When this bearing pressure increases, when this load on the bearing increases, load on the bearing increases, the bearing pressure increases. When the bearing is subjected to high bearing pressure, then there is a chance of reduction in the lubricating oil film thickness, right? As the viscosity is also goes on decreasing here, right? So obviously the Zn by P value decreases. When this Zn by P value decreases, right, slowly the bearing operates into the region between Q and R, the region between Q and R. Okay, so in this region, it is called a partial lubricating region. You will find the metal to metal contact certain part of the time, right? So you will not find a complete metal to metal contact. Similarly, you cannot eliminate complete metal to metal contact. Then and there you will have partial lubrication. That's why some amount of friction developed here. Due to this friction, slowly the coefficient of friction increases. So, and the Z value decreases, right? So due to the increase of friction, the temperature of this lubricating oil increases. As the temperature increases, viscosity decreases. As the viscosity decreases, once again Zn by P value still decreases. Listen carefully. You concentrate on only these three parameters. The decrease in the speed or increase in the pressure causes the decrease of the entire Zn by P value. When this Zn by P value decreases, slowly the bearing moves from point P to Q and later on towards R and later on towards S. When Zn by P value slowly decreases up to point R, then it falls into the region of thin film lubrication, which is known as unstable region. Unstable, that means the complete lubricating oil film is disappeared. That means the decrease in the viscosity of the lubricating oil ceases the metal to metal contact. When the metal to metal contact takes place, obviously the temperature between the journal and the lubricating journal and the bearing clearance increases. As the temperature increases, then heat generation takes place. As the heat is generated, temperature rises, viscosity decreases, thereby Zn by P value increases. But the oiliness of lubricating oil sometimes avoids the metal to metal contact here, right? So between R and S, this is completely unstable region. So we must be careful in avoiding the working of bearing under this region, thin film lubricating region, right? Is it clear? So now here, if you observe the entire plot of this, this point, at this point A, you will find lowest coefficient of friction, right? The Zn by P value corresponding to lowest value of coefficient of friction. Zn by P value corresponding to minimum coefficient of friction. You can write K is equal to Zn by P. But for minimum coefficient of friction, Zn by P for minimum coefficient of friction is known as a bearing modulus, right? It is the property of every bearing. So every bearing will have a certain bearing modulus, right? So based on this bearing modulus, you can say whether the bearing is under hydrodynamic conditions or hydrodynamic conditions or not. So first you need to calculate K value. K is equal to Zn by P value corresponding to minimum coefficient of friction. This you have to remember, or you must be able to differentiate what is bearing characteristic number and what is bearing modulus. Bearing characteristic number is Zn by P. Bearing modulus is also Zn by P. But bearing modulus is only one. For a bearing, you will have only one bearing modulus, that is Zn by P value corresponding to minimum coefficient of friction. You have so many values of Zn by P from this 0 to maximum. Out of this, only one value, at one value, you will find minimum coefficient of friction. That value is known as a bearing modulus. Okay, so that's why generally the bearing modulus, your bearing should not operate less than this bearing modulus value, right? So in order to get the smooth functioning of the bearing or smooth working of the bearing, your bearing characteristic number should be higher than the bearing modulus, should be higher than bearing modulus. The bearing should work in this region Q to P or P to Q. If I take the Zn by P value here, this Zn by P value definitely greater than this K, right? So if you want to maintain the bearing under hydrodynamic condition, the Zn by P value should be greater than bearing modulus for the given bearing. That's why for normal loadings, Zn by P will be considered as 3 times the bearing modulus. For normal loading, generally the bearing modulus, bearing characteristic number, generally considered as 3 times bearing modulus. 3 times bearing modulus. For variable loads or for fluctuating loads, bearing characteristic number is considered as 15 times that of bearing modulus. Right? This is for, or if you want to understand clearly, this is for uniform or static loads. If it is for variable loads, if it is a variable load, the bearing modulus must be, bearing modulus or bearing characteristic number must be 15 times that of bearing modulus, right? So that's why in the design, first you need to find out the bearing modulus value. Once we have bearing modulus, whether the bearing characteristic number is greater than the bearing modulus or not, that you have to check initially, right? If it is greater than the bearing modulus, then the bearing is said to be operate in under hydrodynamic conditions, right? So that is the concept of bearing modulus or bearing characteristic number. Once again, bearing characteristic number is nothing but Zn by P. Bearing modulus is also Zn by P, but bearing modulus is only one for the bearing, that is corresponding to the lowest coefficient of friction of that bearing. Okay. You may have different values of Zn by P for the bearing, but at one Zn by P value, you will find minimum coefficient of friction. That Zn by P is called bearing modulus, right? Always your bearing should operate above the bearing modulus value. Then this falls in this region, right? So if it falls in this region, if it falls in this region, then this is called hydrodynamic condition. Okay, so to maintain the bearing works under this region, for uniform loading or static loading, the bearing characteristic number will be considered as minimum 3 times that of the bearing modulus. For variable loads, it is considered as 15 times that of the bearing modulus.